Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 10 of Java and Web, Interface in Java. In this video, we will learn about interface method naming conflict. There are various cases in which interface method naming conflict can happen. And the first case is when two interfaces have same methods with same name, same signature and same return type, then implementation class can implement only one of them. And in this case, we cannot say about which interface method is getting implemented. For example, we have two interfaces here, interface A and interface B. Both interfaces have the method draw, which is returning void. That's how the name, signature and return type of the method draw in both the interfaces are same. Then after we have the class use, which implements both the interfaces A and B. The class use implements the method draw. But here we are not clear whose draw is implemented by the class use. Is it the method draw of the interface A or is it the method draw of the interface B? We are not clear about this point. But in the implementation of the method draw, we are printing the string draw. Then after the class use has the method main, inside the method main, we create an object of type use and we are calling the method draw by using the reference variable u. That's how this statement will print the string draw. Let me try this code practically. We have a.java, let's open it. And we have the same code as we have seen. Open b.java. This is also the same code as we have seen in the slide. And open use.java. This is also the same code as we have seen in the slide. Let me try to compile all these three Java codes. Java C, strict.java. It compiles fine. Now run it, Java use. It runs fine and printing the string draw. Then after we have the second case of the interface methods naming conflict. In this case, if two interfaces contains methods with same name and different signatures, then in implementation class, we have to provide implementation for both the methods. In this case, methods are considered as overloaded. Return types of methods does not matter in this case. See here, we have the interface A and interface B. Inside the interface A, we have the method draw which returns void and having no formal argument. And inside the interface B, we have the method draw which returns void and having method parameter as integer variable x. In this case, both methods are considered as different methods. So we need to implement both methods in the class use. If we skip any of these implementations, then the compiler will result an error. Inside the method main of the class use, we have created an object of type use. Then we are calling the method draw on the reference variable u. After that, we are calling the method draw with an actual argument 5 by using the reference variable u. So this method call will execute this method body and this method call will execute this method body. Let me try this code practically. Open b.java and write here the formal argument as int x. Now open use.java, copy these four statements, paste it here, write here int x. And print here x, draw plus x. Now we have to call both draw methods. So copy this statement and paste it below. Write here 5. Save and compile this code. Java C, strict.java. Compiles fine. Now run it, Java use. It runs fine and printing draw and draw 5. Now let's open use.java once again and remove these four statements from this line to this line. Now remove this statement u.draw. In this case, the compiler will throw an error because we are not implementing the method draw from the interface A. Let me try to compile this code. Java C, strict.java. The compiler throws an error, use is not abstract and does not override method draw in A. And there is a third case, if two interfaces contains methods with same names, same signatures, but different return types, then we cannot implement both interfaces in same implementation class. We will see this point practically in a while. As we know that we cannot implement two methods in a class who have same name, same signature, but different return types. It does not matter if they are members of that class or belong to different classes or interfaces. Let's practically check meaning of these two points. We have the interface A, which contains the method draw, which returns void. And we have another interface B, which contains the method draw, which returns integer. Then after we have the class use. The class use implements two interfaces, A and B. While implementing these two interfaces in the class use, we need to implement both the methods. If we skip any of these two methods, then the compiler will result an error. But if we include both of these two methods, then also the compiler will result an error. Because a class cannot have two methods with same name, same signature, and different return types. Let me try this code practically. Clear the screen. Open a.java. And I think this code is good. Now open b.java. Right here int draw. And just remove the formal argument. Remove it. Save it. Now open use.java. Remove the comment from this line and this line. Remove the comment from this line and give a comment in this line. Now the method draw should return integer. Right here int. And remove the formal argument x. Return something. Because the method is returning integer, so you also need to return something. Return here. Return 5. And remove the statement x from this line. Now let's try to compile this code. Java C, strict.java. The compiler throws an error. Oh, it's saying it's missing semicolon. Let me correct it. I have to write here a semicolon. Then again try to compile this code. This time the compiler throws an error. Method draw is already defined in the class use. So you can see here you are getting lot of errors. Let me remove one of the method implementations. Let me remove this method implementation. Remove it. Again try to compile this code. Clear the screen. Again you got the error that you are not implementing a method. So here in this case, if the two interfaces having methods with same name and same signature but different return types, then the both interfaces cannot be implemented by a single class. Otherwise you will get an error. Does not matter if you are implementing all the methods of both interfaces or not, or you are skipping some method implementations. In both the cases, you will get errors. Here we have declared the class use as abstract, and we are not implementing any of these two methods. One method draw is returning void, while other method draw is returning integer. But in the class use, we are not implementing any of these two methods, and we have declared the class use as abstract class. Here in this case, again we got an error. Types A and B are incompatible, both define draw, but with unrelated return type. Let me try this code practically. Open use.java and remove this implementation. Just comment out these four statements. And right here, abstract. Remove these two statements also from the method main. I want the empty body of the method main. So remove it. Now save and compile this code. Java C, strict.java. The compiler throws an error. Oh, there is some typo. Remove this I from this statement. Now try to compile this code. Java C, strict.java. The compiler throws an error. Types A and B are incompatible. Both defines draw, but with unrelated return types. So anyhow, if two interfaces contains methods with same name and same signature, but their return types are different, then both interfaces cannot be implemented by single class. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.